Hi, I'm Mike. Farmers and ranchers are in a business that influences, even if you don't realize it, everyone, in some shape or form. But at the same time, there's a disconnect growing larger and larger by the day between rural and urban communities and businesses, leaving many farmers wondering if it's even worth it. Today, we take a look at what is happening and how we can combat the issue and once again, care about agriculture on our Wyoming Life. Welcome back. This week I've been doing a lot of checking cows. It's calving season and I've spent a lot of time in the gator and just driving around, sometimes just sitting and watching, kind of like watching that cow right out there waiting for her to have her calf. While I'm out here, I get a chance to read and catch up on some of the industry news, and today I figured I'd take advantage of a little lull here while we're waiting for her, and I'd share with you what I've been reading about. The wind is starting to blow, so I'm gonna flip around here and we're gonna sit in the gator and have a little chat. I hope that this information resonates with you just a little bit. I hope you think about it, and I hope you share it, because for those of us that eat, this is a big deal. Cam Houle, a dairy farmer, said that farming is the art of losing money while working 400 hours a month to feed people that think you're trying to kill them. Farming here in Northeast Wyoming means ranching. And that might be where the problem begins. If someone asked you to explain the difference between a farm and a ranch, would you be able to? Well, some people use the terms farm and ranch interchangeably, although there are specific differences, and some view farming as wholesome, while ranching may stir up images of outlaws, rustlers, or even a slipshod cowboy. And really, although they can be very different, the product of both end up at your grocery stores and eventually your dinner tables. Both farms and ranches can be small or large. They're all tended to by hardworking individuals who care way more than you think. I've heard it said that ranches are farms. All ranches are farms, but not all farms are ranches. Now, a farm is a term to describe a plot of land that primarily focuses on producing agriculture. They can produce from food to fuel to raw materials like cotton. Although a farm is usually focused on growing crops, there are dairy farms and hog farms and poultry farms that are popular types as well. Now, it's been stated that farms are usually smaller than ranches, but it doesn't mean the workload is any different. In fact, a ranch is just a specific type of farm. Ranches usually carry cattle or sheep, and the primary focus is the animals, while at the same time farming natural or seeded grasses off the countryside to feed those animals. So we go back again and we ask, what's the difference between a farm and a ranch? And I'm gonna go out on a limb here and say there's no difference. The goal of a farm or a ranch, 10 acres or 10,000, is to provide for the masses, to take on that responsibility and do it safely. In the 1890s, each farmer in the U.S. grew enough each year to feed on average 3 to 5 people. 100 years later, in 1995, that number had grown to each farmer feeding 128 people. We went from 90% of the population living on farms to 1%. And today, that number has grown even more, with one U.S. farm annually feeding 165 people. Now, the global population is expected to increase to 9.7 billion by 2050, which means that between now and then, farmers are going to have to grow about 70% more food than what is now produced. Food today that arrives at your dinner table and plate travels an average of 1,500 miles, and more than likely was produced on an industrial scale farm. In fact, only 8% of U.S. farms market food locally. Corporations and industrial farms control the global food system. The 5 largest supermarket companies control 46% of all food sales. That means they can take risks and control the price and what the farmer makes off his own product. American farmers continue to produce more and more food, but receive less and less of each dollar spent at the retail level. Recently, the farmer's share of the retail food market has hit an all-time low. According to the USDA, for every dollar consumers spend on food, the farmer receives just 14 cents, and it shows a decrease of 5% from the last year. Beef producers receive less than $2 per pound last year for beef that cost an average of $10 at the grocery store, 50% difference from only 4 years before. Wheat farmers, 12 cents on a loaf of bread that costs $3.49, and that's a drop of 25% over the last 4 years. And dairy producers are receiving an average of $1.34 from a $5 gallon of milk, showing a loss of 20% since 2014. Food has become big business. The rest of the cost producers are paying goes for what is called cost beyond the gate. Wages and material for production, processing, marketing, transportation, and distribution. While the CEOs of the largest retail supermarkets make salaries of $10 to $20 million per year, farmers and ranchers are finding themselves struggling to deal with the stresses that continue to lean on them. From antibiotic use, to GMOs, to hormones, farmers today are facing challenges when it comes to selling their products that those back in the 1800s would have never dreamed of at all, all while being pressured to produce more with less. Where is the breaking point? When will the system collapse? Because the course it's on now will not sustain the added stress. There is a better way, and that's going to come from the consumer, citizens, and elected officials, not powerful multinational corporations taking control of trade policies, informing the public where their food is grown and who benefits. We need to favor family-owned sustainable farms, fair prices, and local food systems. But it's much easier said than done. Country of origin labeling ensures that consumers can make informed decisions about their food purchases and help them support domestic producers if they want to. Bills that ensure farmers a fair price, in which taxpayers are not feeding a lopsided subsidy system, and good things like community food projects, such as farmers markets. Programs like farmers markets and community-supported agriculture build local food systems by purchasing products directly from local and regional farmers and keeping money circulating in local communities. In fact, one state's agricultural agency, Vermont, stated that if consumers shifted just 10% of their food purchases into locally grown food products, that would add more than $100 million to the state's economy. USA Today says that the average family of four spends nearly $800 a month on groceries. If only $80 of that was spent on the local level, that could make a huge difference. But hey, let's be realistic. Finding local produce, meat, or even a milk supplier is hard. It might mean an extra few minutes of your time, or a little more in gas. Plus, you may not find what you're looking for. In fact, our daughter Mackenzie is still looking for the farmer that raises M&Ms. And I doubt she'll ever find him. Is it important to you? Because I guarantee it's important to the farmer. The food that he strives to feed your family is the same he feeds his own. And he's not out to kill you. In fact, he may be the only one who's really looking out for you. Our local food business started small, but I'm proud to say that we're part of the 8% of U.S. farms that market locally. It's not easy, but it's worth it. Local sales buy our kids' clothes and put money away for educations and support everything we do. If you're producing and not selling locally, I would encourage you to do so, even if it's just a small percentage, because the benefits are amazing. By selling locally, we set our prices. We meet the consumer face-to-face, and we build relationships that build towards a healthier food system. Thanks for coming along with me today, and thanks for sharing something that needs said. We're all part of a team that's important to the health and stability of our nation, from the teacher to the fireman, and yes, even the farmer. No one's any more important than the other, but you take one away, and the whole system suffers. Please subscribe as we continue to explore the ranch life and strive to bring those closer to agriculture and the families behind it. If you'd like to know more, go to Facebook, sign up for the group, All Things Agriculture. Talk to the producers that make the food and those that support the industry. Ask questions, and if you have answers, you can help others learn too. Join us on Tuesday once again as calving continues. We have a storm front moving in, and that always means that things are going to get very interesting around here over the next week or so. That cow is still standing back there, and she's not doing anything. But we're going to keep an eye on her. So until I see you again, have a great week, and thanks for joining us in our Wyoming Life.